We're at Oaks today. It's like waking up from an amazing dream into a nightmare. Back in Southern California, it's a little dry, a little chunky, less flowy.
And no big jumps.
No jumps. But there's thrills on this trail. I've gone over my bars a few times and paid the price. Got a scar on my face. I'm here with Boyd. The objective is don't get hurt before Whistler. It's like, what,
right.
8 weeks away?
Yep. Dry and dry.
Yeah. All right.
Ready?
Yeah. Are you going that new way?
Yeah.
All right, I'll go the old way. We'll see if it's faster. That line at the top was new to me. Trout at Fox Raceway on Tuesday.
Hey, Joey.
What up?
How are you going to transition all that momentum into outdoors?
Let's hope we get lucky, right?
Nah, dude, come on.
Yeah.
I mean, the confidence carries over, doesn't it?
Yeah, I mean, for me, I'm just trying to work hard and be as prepared as I can for the first one. But it's another challenge, you know? New bike, Haven't ridden outdoors too much on it, but luckily, unlike past years, we have a couple off weekends, so we have some time to, a little bit more time, you know? But yeah, it should be interesting, but I feel like there's a couple dudes that I've had a little bit more time on outdoors, so they're ahead of the game, but I think we're in a good spot. Yeah, we'll find out. Hopefully Brock did all the testing good enough and I don't have to do anything.
Yeah, how is Brock at testing for you?
Supercross is good because we're able to bounce ideas off of each other. Outdoors, he's kind of been left to his own to figure out, like, to get make progress. And I'm trying his settings right now, you know? And it's, for me, first of all, getting used to outdoors is different. And then the new bike's different. And I'm hoping just to get comfortable. And I think, I think we did a good job Supercross. And I think that we can hopefully work that out in outdoors.
When you get off Supy into motocross, what's the gnarliest thing, the speeds or the bumps?
Speeds.
Huh?
Yeah, it's really crazy because, like, I remember the first day I rode before our break and we did outdoors at Glen Helen, and I was like, dude, I was like blinking. Like, I was like, I'm not used to go, like, just the miles per hour, stuff's coming at you faster. But right now I don't feel too bad, but we gotta get those speeds faster, right?
What do you think about your new teammate that got announced today?
Yeah, Joey, this is the first time being Joey's teammate since 2014. We are teammates on Rockstar KTM.
Okay.
And plus, last year we rode at the same facility and stuff, so yeah, I know Joey pretty well, so I think it's gonna be a good little good summer for us. It's gonna be fun.
Proud to see you win.
Now, thank you.
You won a national, four in the national,
I've won a bunch of motos, never won an outdoor or an overall. I've gone 1-2 and I've seen guys go like freaking like 3-4 and get an overall, and I'm like, what about me? I've won a bunch of motos, but we need to get that elusive overall.
Yeah. Hey, well, you'd be like opening the floodgates, right?
Let's hope one comes and they just keep more and more and more. That'd be nice, but the summer's brutal and just gotta keep our head down and progress.
Back at the headquarters, knocked some shows out today because I'll be gone for the next 2 weeks. Going to Redbud, track and trail on Monday to ride KTMs, and then Renee and I are leaving the following week to go to Barcelona, Spain, just to test the Stark Varg. Got a guy tickling today. What's up, bro?
Bro.
I still think Chase should host some SML shows like Anton does, give it a variation. Wait, don't you think so?
Might as well.
Chase should do it.
I gotta do research on riders.
Come on.
There's only a few in this set,
but... I'm pissed, dude. I want to see number 20 line up this summer.
I mean, there's a huge part of me that still wanted to do it, obviously, but obviously Cowie, they hired me to test.
Yeah.
I'm helping Jason, I'm helping Jet, so
yeah,
my plate's pretty full and things are going well for Jason, so.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I'm not frustrated with it. I'm having a good time with the team, so.
Are you worried about losing 20?
Absolutely. Yeah. That's the only thing holding me to it right now, so.
Yeah.
I'm going to try to convince the guys to let me just at least do the last two. And
yeah. How many points do you have to get to keep it?
25.
25 points.
Yeah. So.
It's like two top 10 finishes?
I mean, if you went top 10, you would pretty much get it.
Yeah.
So.
You could pull that easy.
I think if you go 8-8, that would be 26 points.
Mm-hmm.
So. I mean, that's not out of reach. I mean, there are some guys, obviously we saw some signings the last couple of days, obviously yeah. Joey, Shane, but that's only for the first four.
Well, Dino's asshole heels.
Yeah. So you got Caroli.
Where's Max going to go? I heard he's going back to the GP.
I have
four
no idea.
Hurlings or something.
Yeah, I have no idea.
That or it sounds like that KTM 250 ride stuff.
Is that? Where's Antsy on a 250?
He might be all right. Yeah. He's a good outdoor rider.
Yeah, I know.
And even in Supercross, like I watched him this year, I thought he looked good. Mm-hmm. The class was just gnarly in the beginning. So yeah. A lot of those guys that disappeared, you know, halfway through, that were finishing 16th would have been at 7th or 8th in the end.
Yeah.
So top 10s could have been available.
Damn it. We got Chase's bike up there today. The rider dies.
It's a good looking bike though.
Enduro, right?
Orange.
I want to ride
the forks match the Shelly helmet.
Because I just got a Stumpy.
You and Carabinos.
Yeah, do you ride that Stumpy with Liker though, huh?
No, I got FXR. I got the FXR bike gear. So.
But wait, did you get the FXR short shorts?
No.
Dude, they sent me some baggies that were like mid-thigh.
Really? The ones I have were over my knees.
Okay, I told them that made me feel uncomfortable.
I feel like with the Stumpy or anything over 130, you have to run the
baggies. Yeah, do you have a visor helmet?
Yep.
Oh, dude. Proud of you, bro.
Yeah.
Because that first post, you were still in a spandex kit.
Yep.
I was like, no, bro.
Yeah. I need to upgrade my attire.
Are you singing today?
I don't know, dude. My voice is pretty messed up.
we could pull up the tune on an iPhone and you could just sing away.
We'll see how I'm feeling.
Okay, well, you might as well pull this song up now. Have it in staging.
Thinking.
I don't know. What day was the karaoke?
It was like karaoke Fridays, and then I started racing, and it got messed up, so I switched it to like Wednesdays, and then now I'm I haven't even done it lately, so we gotta bring it back, man.
Bring it back. Might as well start today.
Yeah.
Okay, we're at the bike house in San Clemente.
I picked him up from the
My buddy
UPS
Diego
after
opened the shop up last year. And anyway, I crashed last night at Oaks and bent my derailleur hanger. I'm supposed to ride at San Clemente this morning. So there's no time to drive all the way to Upland to Roy's. So I came here. So I will say, this is the world's second coolest bike shop. But actually, super cool place. Sell Specialized, Cervelo, Fox stuff. But they have a really good mechanic here as well. So, San Clemente, the bike house, check it out. All right, Diego.
What's up, guys?
We met at Rockin' Road back in the day before I left because of bad jap. And you left as well and started your own place. How scary is it to start your own business?
Extremely scary, especially right? With no money.
Yeah.
And we opened and we're here for over a year and a half now. Yeah.
It looks like things are going well.
Yes, sir.
Dude, that's awesome.
Please come check us out.
So, out of curiosity, when you're a brand new shop like this, mm-hmm. like is the bulk of your income from bike sales or service?
Because we didn't really have a lot of bikes and it was hard to get bikes and parts, so it was service.
Service
was like 70% service. And now it's almost like half and half.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Because more bikes are coming.
You're a Specialized dealer, Cervelo.
Specialized, Cervelo, and Scott.
Oh, Scott.
Yeah.
The Scott we were just talking about. Scott
yes, sir.
Yeah. Stuff. Okay, cool. You get jam-packed in here. All the service bikes go in the middle.
Yeah, go old service in the middle, and then new bikes go around.
Because there's
boxes
no backroom,
all
right?
over.
There's no backroom here.
No,
right?
There's no backroom.
Yeah. So, what's your service turnaround here?
2 days.
2 days.
At most.
Okay,
doesn't
pretty
matter.
Fast then.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you got to get the shit out of here for room. Right?
And yes, and is if we don't, we have some freelancer mechanics too.
Oh, okay.
So if we need more people, we bring it in and get done in 2 days.
Regardless. Yeah. Okay, so we're in San Clemente, California.
San Clemente.
And is the bulk of your business and customers mountain or road?
It's 60% mountain.
60%
because we have a bunch of trails around us here.
Yeah, yeah. We got my favorite trail up the street.
Yeah.
So I came in for a last minute repair because I crashed last night. Thank you for taking care of me.
Of course.
And yeah, guys, come check out the bike house in San Clemente. We are back at AP Designs. They handled a couple of test rider helmets for us. We're at AP and we're with the man, AP himself. Did you ever think about calling your paint place something different than your initials?
No, actually, because...
Everyone calls you AP,
everybody
right?
called me AP long before I started this, you know? So it's just, it was always my nickname, so I figured why not?
It's funny because when we got laid off from Transworld, we already had the Swapmoto Live show that we did at Transworld.
Yep.
And so that was kind of like no-brainer because we had equity in the name already. So we called our new media company Swapmoto Live. Now, 3 years in, I wish I'd called something else.
Oh, yeah?
Because I've got staff guys that kick ass, right? Like Chase and Anton.
Uh-huh.
I don't want them to feel like they're working for a company named after me, right?
Oh, yeah.
So we're trying to call it SML.
And there you go.
If people say, what's SML? Supercross, motocross lifestyle, bro.
Yeah, there you go. That's awesome. Yeah, no, it just stuck, you know, and people have always called me AP long before I started this, so it was kind of fitting, I guess, at the time.
Okay,
but that was 31 years ago, so still
right? How old are we, dude? We're like dust.
Dude, I feel like a dinosaur.
Okay, so you did a couple of our test rider helmets, simple, easy design.
Yep.
What is the hardest helmet physically to work with? Like one with the worst curves and the most plastic and currently.
I don't want to throw any helmet companies under the bus, but I would have to say Arai. There's just so many pieces.
And to do
them right, you got to take off everything. A lot of
guys those vents on the back, right?
They got vents on the back, like on the road race helmet. They got two big vents on the top, a lot of hardware underneath, a vent on the top, like ear pods on the sides that got to come off.
Yeah.
And
so that's
a rotor. You could leave it on, but then you get a little overspray here and there, and it just doesn't look like it came that way.
What about moto helmet? What's the toughest moto helmet, like shape-wise to me? Because, I mean, there's shapes that are easy to look good and shapes that are probably hard to work a design with, right?
No, they're all pretty easy to work a design with. Mm-hmm. I would say one thing I run into with the Alpine Stars helmet is limited real estate, especially with the amount of helmets we do, like monster helmets or sponsor logos, they take up a lot of real estate.
Yeah.
And with the Alpine Stars, once all those logos are in place, there's very little real estate left to paint.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. When you do an Alpine Stars helmet, do you have to paint like 5 extra visors?
No, we haven't, but only for Chase.
Yeah. Dude. Yeah, those things fly.
He pops visors off a lot. He's actually the only one that really loses a lot of visors.
Mm-hmm.
So, but you know. Get roosted by 450 mud, they pop off.
Okay, so. I know that RV got a helmet like every race, pretty much. Who of the current crop of motocross guys is the most spoiled by you?
I would probably have to say Tomac.
Tomac?
Yeah.
Yeah, he gets them pretty often.
He gets a lot.
He kind of deserves it, though.
He kind of deserves it, you know. And he's just fun to work with. You know, he loves the designs. Uh-huh. You know, especially we've done some recent stuff that hasn't been seen yet that he's pretty pumped on, so.
He's always into the USA Eagle
kind of stuff. Yep, yep. Huh? We're kind of steering away from that now. He kind of was like, all right, let's move on to something else. But yeah, he loved it for a long time.
You know, I think the Eagle was his dad's deal, too. Johnny T on his mountain bike helmets, right?
Yeah, I believe so.
Hmm. How about mountain bike helmets? Do you paint a lot of those?
Quite a bit.
Yeah?
Quite a bit.
Like downhill stuff, though, right?
Downhill stuff.
But not half shells.
No, we do a lot. We do a lot of half shells, too, but mostly downhill.
Yeah.
You know, we do guys like Loris and Charlie Harrison and Connor Fearon, you know, a lot of the top dudes.
The half shell mountain bike helmets are hard to paint, huh? Because they're...
Well, there's so many vents. There's no real estate. So vented up that there's hardly any real estate on them to get creative with, you know?
And do you peel the hard shell off to paint that, or you tape it?
No, we have to tape it.
Oh, that's so much tape.
It's a nightmare. It's a nightmare.
I thought about having a half shell painted once, but I'm all... I fucking hit my head on a mountain bike, like, once a week. Like, Benny sends me helmets in fours. Because I'm always smashing them, you know? Like, it'd be kind of stupid to unpaint it.
Yeah. No, if you're going to... That's the thing. It's not when you're... It's not if, it's when. You're going to ruin it, you know, eventually, so...
All right, so you do the Monster helmets. You're on contract with Monster. And I know they always want solid black with... You started that thing, right? Years ago?
Yep.
That was such a good deviation from that. That added some color and some spice.
Yeah, the first time we did that was for snowcross guy, Paul Thacker.
Oh, it was an RV.
Yep, it was an RV.
I've never seen an RV.
We did it for Paul first, and he started calling it the Skittles.
Skittles, yeah.
And then it kind of took off for a while. Because at the time, each one of those colors represented a flavor that they had.
Oh, okay.
So those were all one of the Monster flavors, except for the neutral one. That was just, you know, thrown in there.
So are they relaxing a little on the all black, big green M?
No, they still prefer everything all black. Yeah. It's just some of the top guys, they're, you know, they feel they're deserving of custom helmets, so they allow that.
Is that Twitch helmet still here?
No, he's got it.
Yeah, no, that thing was cool. I had a lot of variation.
Yeah, Brandon threw down on that one. That was badass.
Do you have anything back there that's cool I could see?
A couple things that are in the process.
Yeah, let's see. What's the...
Speaking of a rise and having to take them all apart.
You got one apart?
Yeah, I'll show you. This one is... this is for one of our guys, J.D. Beach, flat track guy. So this is a tribute, because I don't know if you know Earl... Hayden just passed away recently.
Oh, he did?
And so this is a tribute to Nikki and Earl. Mm-hmm. So we've got that going on the back.
That's awesome.
So, and then obviously Earl's racing team was his deal. And then that's the Nikki Stars that he used to use. So this is a variation of one of Nikki Hayden's old helmets.
Hey, the flat track helmets, do you clear coat them extra? Because they take such a beating from that roof?
No, our clear coat hardens up really, really well. It's really durable. So we haven't had them. Most of the guys will get through an entire season with a couple helmets.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Huh. This is an old school paint job.
Yep.
The guy wanted metal flake flames.
Per request of the customer. Yep. Those still get outlined and, you know, brush stroke around them all.
Who's that over there?
That's just another customer fun working on. Yep.
Yeah, that's good. So I think are the Moto 10s hard because the shell's two pieces and all that?
No,
it's easier to work with.
Again, they have cool lines and a lot of real estate. There's a lot, you know what I mean? There's a lot to work with on them.
Mm-hmm. I like when you let the raw carbon show through.
I love it.
That's a great design element.
You know what? It's so much better than just a black or base coat, you know what I mean? It's just got way more character.
Yeah.
A lot of times we'll shoot some candies over them and make the carbon appear to be bluish carbon or red, you know, which that's also
You know what
fun.
This looks like? Are you holding back on me? Is that like is this a sample for a new production graphic?
Nope.
That's what it looks like. It's clean. Yeah.
It's nice and clean.
Yeah, I like that.
So.
Some people
just like them clean and simple, you know.
Is there an Eli Tomac helmet here in progress?
Not.
Nothing?
There will be next week.
Of course, right?
You want to pop back in and get behind the scenes. We got a ton for Paula for the opening round.
Oh, yeah?
So, yeah, we've got about 30 helmets to get ready for that.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah. Oh, I better get out of your hair.
boss man though could have the prettiest one, right?
Yeah. Oh, they got AP style names though. These are good. It's a beautiful Thursday morning. We're here at Skyline. Got Nando piloting the Husqvarna Hard Cross pedal assist bike. That thing's so badass with those forks, huh? 38s.
Yeah. Fun bike for sure.
Renee, international traveler Garcia. Renee and I are leaving for Barcelona, Spain in about 10 days.
Just about.
Is this gonna be your first trip to Europe?
Yeah, first trip. I'm so excited, dude.
It's gonna be sick.
I don't think I've stopped smiling since got the news. So
you got your green card all renewed?
Yeah. We're all legit on the green card. Si habla inglés.
Yeah. Renee's gonna be our translator throughout Spain. It'll be good. Spanish crosses over, right?
Yeah, should.
You just need to know how to say, there's no shrimp in that, right? You know, for me, that's all I need you to learn how to say. But we're going to hit Trencherous. Last time I went down it, I went head first into a bush and got a stick through my helmet. So, try to avenge myself. What happened? Oh! What?
Yeah.
You good? Yeah, dude, this shit is slippery today. And you know what's scary about this, Renee? This is the easy part. Get clipped in, swap. Yeah, that's where we turned off before back there. Yeah. Well, that wasn't exactly avenging myself. We're at State Fair. We can't confirm it with the manager, but it's widely believed that this is the last normal open practice day before the track gets shut down by the state. So, we're racing here with the Swapmoto Race Series this weekend. Time to dust the cobwebs off. I've been in Salt Lake for a week and soak it all in. This track State Fair has yielded a lot of good times for me. So, wearing my FXR gold and white kit, trying out my new Polar watch. I'm gonna leave the little clear plastic chingus on to protect it. Weighing at Polar, sent Chase and I some watches. We're super stoked. Totally have mixed emotions about this place. Really come to love it in recent years. Had a lot of good rides here, a lot of good races. The negative is back when it was called Star West, before it was reopened and titled State Fair, this is the track where my big brother Ross got paralyzed like 13 years ago. Pretty crazy to think that it's gonna be gone. This is actually where I met Scrub Daddy a long time ago, when he was a fat kook. We got the kamikaze pilot, Masa, back in action. First two, but yeah, using good sense and riding behind you. Ha ha ha! you call gully? TGIF Friday, and it's 90 degrees today. Just in time for the race this weekend. Back out here with Fernando Husqvarna, hard cross pilot. Yeah. But all I did yesterday was fall down, so we're gonna try not to fall down today. Caldera on Friday the 13th. Oh, turtle guy today. What happened?
You almost caught
that car. Got caught on what?
On the side of the...
Oh, no way?
Yeah.
Damn, dude. This wouldn't be a good cliff to fly off. Man, that's crazy. this trail is called Lockdown. It was built in 2019 during the COVID lockdown. You know, 2 weeks to flatten the curve. But yeah, I think I haven't ridden it since then. There's actually a new entrance. Felt like that was gonna break. Something a little different this Saturday. We're at Barona Oaks down in Ramona. Steve and I are here. It's about what? Hour and a half ride?
At least that.
Hour and a half drive. You haven't ridden here in how long?
Probably 10 years since I've been here.
Yeah, it's been a long time for me as well. At least 5, 6. I remember this is the place covering a CMC race. The first time I ever met Ryan Hughes was down here. When he was, I think he's like 17 and he had braces, JT Dalmatian gear. Anyway, Scrub Daddy's been coming here a bunch and raving about it, so I thought we'd do something different. He was blending in with the trees and everything. I didn't see you.
You like that?
Hey, they let anybody in here. Yeah, even
people
hikers.
Like
even
that
hikers like
even
you.
Even hikers.
Where do you want me to park?
Alright, man, you can park right here. Alright. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I don't want you to get in trouble for parking with the
nids. Watch this, I'ma get him.
Play that game, play the fight game, you know. You know, you fight around your fellas and it's funny. Dudes be doing that, they be getting in the elevators and fighting and laughing and shit.
How is it fun?
No, put it on the ground, make sure it's level though.
Yeah.
Yeah, we went from 2.5 to 1.5.
Oh, you fucking
The doggers at O'Neill right
now. I know, I saw you're still hauling ass though. I was like, oh shit, I see the number 4, I better go.
What up?
Dogger.
Verona time.
What's up, man?
How's it going?
Good, man.
See you, man.
You too, buddy.
Yeah, cool.
Mount Morris, like 1984 is the last time I seen you.
Oh.
What is that helmet?
Hey! O'Neill Riders!
What is that helmet?
What do you mean with this helmet? It's a bell. Rock the bell, huh? Y'all didn't give me one. I see everybody else got the flex.
You got how many Moto 10s I've gotten you and you went
out. Yeah, but wait,
but the one that I wanted, I saw all y'all got it, the carbon, so I went and bought this one. Eli Tomac won, so I, you know.
Let me see the back. You got the eagle on the back. You should have a chicken.
The eagle has landed.
We gotta get an eagle, so it's a chicken.
Wait, what?
You gotta get a chicken on the back.
Idiot.
Scrubby taking the girls behind the trailer. Dude. You know what it is? They all want to know if it's true.
Oh, what? I think I got a couple questions. I want to know if it's true.
Why are you taking the girls behind the trailer?
Is this the behind?
She wanted to come over here.
Is this behind the scenes for the O'Neill shoot? Am I in the right spot?
What's going on? Oh, she gonna sing?
She's gonna sing.
She's gonna sing live. Watch. She's thinking about it. All right, go. Half past ten. Another six pack in. And I can really rumble like a cold black wind. He pulls in the drive. Grab my. You don't know what's waiting here this time. I'm going home to load my shotgun. We by the door.
Wait, Dogger, there's no jersey in there.
Oh, yeah. What?
Hey, and then when did you become an O'Neill rider?
I'm just kind of testing out some different stuff.
Oh, okay.
Trying to find what I like and what fits me.
Why don't you just cut your jerseys off at the elbow?
And then they won't stay up. You need that elastic right there.
Yeah.
God dang it.
Dude. Is that gear bag from like
95?
95, the JT Flame bag.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was the year of JT's. Hell yeah. Gracias. I gotta need to sign this one.
So, Rita gave me this.
So this is your regular jam, huh, Barona?
This is it, man. Normally not in this shape, but.
What about that track that we did the 100% intro on?
That's Bo Ranch.
Yeah.
Right out there once in a while as well.
Yeah. and goons out here.
Yeah, it is. Those goons that aren't supposed to try to go too fast to get around.
Yeah. Thousand times a lap. Look how shiny it is right there. It's shiny from the end. Hey, I just showed your bike something it's never had.
What?
Yeah, right. He knows. He saw me in front of you. Hey, he gonna see that. That's all he gonna see tomorrow is the 135
on the side of the track. Yeah, so I missed my shift from second to third. Yeah, I missed it.
Oh, yeah.
And I saw y'all. Right. Oh, it's him. No way.
Race number 15.
Dude, I ran into that wall so hard on the outside.
On the vent track. This is going to be the 85 starter.
That was fun, though.
This one is going to be good. They are all stacked
up. Did I see you using your phone?
Fully full. This one's going to be a heater.
Were you taking pictures or using your phone?
Who's
going to
get the whole shot?
Oh, I thought I saw you
laugh. No, I didn't record you. Oh.
Thank you.
So I eat shit at a state fair in the second moto in the mud, fell on my face, tweaked my neck, gonna get frozen.
So you rode it in one last time?
Yeah, so.
It was just today?
Yeah, about an hour ago.